Sustainable development has a long history, but don't worry, I'm not going to get into that here. Now, my story starts with a message. You and I are too young to remember this, but about 20 years ago, there was a UN summit in Rio called the Earth Summit. Its aim was to find new ways to develop our planet, taking into account all our needs while respecting our natural environment. But the conference didn't achieve this. Speaking at the event on behalf of the world's youth, a young girl said, "This conference has ensured increased domination by those who already have power. It has robbed the poor of the little power they had and made us all victims of a market economy that has threatened our planet." Now, I hear you asking, haven't things changed since then? Well, let's put it this way. The world now has about 7 billion people in it, and its wealth now amounts to $60 trillion. No, that's two more zeros. But although the planet has never been richer, the environment has never been worse off, and the gap between rich and poor keeps getting wider and wider, day after day. Okay, so what can we do about this? We've got two options. We could throw in the towel and basically let the world perish, or we could call on world leaders to truly commit to what they promised to do 20 years ago and prepare the world for what's to come in order to avoid letting future generations, that means you and I, carry the burden. If you've decided to go for option two, you'll be glad to know that next June there's going to be a second Earth Summit in Rio that people are calling Rio+20. To help us frame the debate a bit, the UN has set out two themes for this summit, called the Green Economy and the Institutional Framework. The Green Economy is about education and knowledge, about the food we eat and the energy we use, about cities and transport. In short, it's about how we lead our everyday lives. The Institutional Framework is about political structures, both local and global, about how you and I can participate in these structures and about how they work. You're probably thinking, what can I do about this? Well, most importantly, you can get involved in the process. And the best part is, the UN wants you to participate. At the 1992 Earth Summit, it started giving civil society, that means you and me, or major groups to use the UN term, a role in the process. And that's been growing ever since. For the Rio Summit in June, the UN has already called 8 times for our participation. We have to fill that space. Remember, this is not some old people's summit. This is your generation's summit. Rio+20 is Rio for 20-somethings. And right now, it seems we're still talking like it's 1992. Like the language and the people who are going to be at the summit are left over from the last century. But I have to warn you about something. For the first couple of months that you're active, you might not generate as much impact as you like. You might be very passionate and committed. You might feel that your work is falling short. It takes a while. It will take you a while. But you just have to fight your way through that, okay? Don't give up. And hear this, you're not alone. This fight you're carrying on, others have already started it. There are lots of young volunteers out there trying to make this whole complex story understandable and finding ways to fine-tune it. So check out rioplus20s.org. Join us and let's get moving. Another world is possible.